Hello everyone. So today I'm gonna show you how you can install KOReader on your jailbroken Kindle. We all know that the biggest benefit of jailbreaking a Kindle is the ability to install KOReader because it has a lot of features, especially when you are reading PDF files. First of all, I'm gonna plug this Kindle into my computer, just like this. Okay. Now that it is plugged in, I'm gonna go to my computer screen. As you can see, this is the official website of KOReader. So they have different distributions for different devices. If you click download, then it will take you to the GitHub repository of the KOReader. From there, you can download the latest versions of KOReader. But the problem with the latest version is that since the jailbreak has just become available, it is not yet supported for the latest jailbroken Kindle. That's why you have to use another version of KOReader, which I will link in the description below. So that is the nightly build, a slightly older version of the KOReader, but the process will be same. And in future, when the latest version of KOReader will support the latest jailbroken Kindles, then you can just download from here. So I'm gonna show you how you can download it. For example, let's say these are all the releases for different devices. So for the Kindle, there are two versions, like one is Kindle Legacy and another is Kindle. So what you have to do is you have to just click on it and then download the zip file, just like this. I'm not gonna install this version. I have another version downloaded on my computer already, which I have extracted in this folder, as you can see. So these are the two folders that is required you to install KOReader on your Kindle. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open a new tab on my file manager and then open the Kindle directory, because my Kindle is already connected to the computer. It will show the Kindle's root directory, and I will just copy these two folders which I have downloaded and extracted from the zip file, and then paste it into the Kindle's root directory, just like this. Since this is a pretty big file, 97 megabytes, it will take some time to install. My Kindle is using micro USB port for data transfer, that's why it's a bit slow, but in your case, your Kindle might use type C port. In that case, the data transfer rate will be faster. So I'm gonna wait for the copying process to be finished. Remember again, for now, you cannot install the latest version of the KOReader from the GitHub repository because it will not work on your Kindle until the developers fix that problem. So until then, you have to use the nightly build, which I will provide the link in the description below. The process is all the same. And in future, if you want to update your KOReader, in that case, you can just download the updated files and then replace, just like this. The process will be all the same. It is almost done. Okay, so the copy process has been done. Now I'm gonna unplug the Kindle from my computer. Okay, just like this. And if we go to the home of the Kindle, then we have to open Kual, and then we can see that there is KOReader added into our list. So we click in here and then we will click on start KOReader. As you can see at the bottom, it says starting KOReader. That means the KOReader has started already. So this is the quick start guide of KOReader, and it will give you a quick overview how you can use the KOReader. I'm gonna skip this and go to the file browser. So this is the file browser of Kindle. From here you can browse your book files and then open. And this is the home button of KOReader. You can go to the KOReader's home, then you can see the documents folder. Inside these you can keep any files and then you can read. You can keep files in other folders too, unlike Kindle's default UI. I'm gonna show you how you can exit the KOReader. So for this you have to touch anywhere at the top header, and then you will see that this is the KOReader menu. From here you can go to KOReader settings and other options, and from here you will see that there's an exit option. So you have to click on exit, and then there is an option to restart KOReader, then sleep mode, and then exit. So if you click exit, it will take you to the home page of your Kindle, I mean the default UI. Okay, so we have already come back to the default UI of Kindle. So from here I'm gonna go to home. So as you can see, even after installing KOReader, things are all the same. You can use your Kindle as always. You can read PDF books, EPUB, KFX, or anything in your default UI. But if you want extra functionality, only then you can launch the KOReader, or you can always be inside the KOReader if you prefer that more. So I'm gonna plug in the USB cable to load a PDF file to show you how it looks on KOReader. Now that the USB is connected, I'm gonna go to my PC, and this is my Kindle's directory, and I have a test PDF here. So I'm gonna move this to the downloads folder in here. You can put this anywhere. So I'm gonna paste this inside download folder, inside the documents folder of Kindle. So it will take some time to load the PDF. Okay, now that it is done, I'm gonna unplug my Kindle. Okay. Now, as you can see, this is the default reader, and if we open the PDF in here, it looks like this. It does not have much functionality in here. So reading PDF in Kindle is not always convenient. But after we jailbreak and install KOReader, reading is much more easier. So what we have to do is we have to go to Kual and then go to KOReader and then start KOReader. Now it will start KOReader. Just wait for it to start, and then this is the home page of KOReader. As you can see, all the directories are here. So you go to your documents, because we have put the PDF in the downloads folder inside documents folder. So this is the PDF file. As you can see, it is showing all the metadata. So we will click on it, and it's opening. So this is the KOReader. As you can see, I can clearly see that the KOReader is faster than the default PDF reader on Kindle. There are various options. For example, we can go to the settings of KOReader. Then here you can change contrast, font size, reflow on or off. So by right now the reflow is off, and if we turn on PDF reflow, so it will look like an EPUB book. It is more easier to read and everything is very nice. There are a lot of features in the KOReader. I'm gonna create another video to show you all the features. If you want to keep your Kindle like this and then go to sleep, for example, I'm gonna lock my Kindle and then it will show that it's sleeping. So right now it's in sleep mode and it will preserve the battery. Also, it will preserve the state. You don't need to exit KOReader. And then when you unlock the Kindle, and then you can start reading from here. I mean, if you use KOReader regularly, then you don't need to exit KOReader any time. You can just launch directly from KOReader. But if you want to go to the default UI back, then you can exit KOReader just like I showed you earlier. You just click in here and then click on exit, and it will exit to the default UI. So that's it for now. Thank you very much.